friends, welcome to a new video. If you are new here, my name is Rochelle. This week is officially the first week I am done my second semester of junior year of university, which is actually so crazy because I cannot believe that another year has passed. And in September, I'm going to be a senior, and that is absolutely mind-blowing. It is actually so scary how quickly time flies. Anyways, just because I did finish school and I am now on summer break, I thought I would just sit down with you guys and reflect on my past junior year of university online because of COVID. This past year isn't my first time doing online school. I actually did a little bit of online school in high school. In high school, I only did online summer school, and that was only for about a month. And then in university, last year, I did online summer school for about a month and a half long, 2 months long. But up until this past year, I haven't done online school long-term before. So in this video, I really just want to reflect and share with you my experience. If your experience of online school and school in general during this pandemic is different or similar in any way, let me know in the comments down below. I'm really interested in hearing your story and your experience of how school was like for you this past year. Before we get into this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, click the bell icon to stay up to date when and what I post, and give this video a thumbs up. And with that, let's just get into this video. All right, before I get into the pros and cons of online school based on my experience, I thought I would just give you a little bit of context to how my school and my program ran this past year. I am in an arts program in university. I am a film production major, so the majority of my classes were online, but because I am a film major, a lot of my work consists of projects, specifically group projects. So at times for these group projects, I had to go in person to complete them. Moving on to the actual reflection process on my experience of online school, the first topic I want to cover is health and well-being. The first pro to online school I have is, of course, it reduces the chance of catching COVID. I think it goes without saying that if you stay home and you're not around a lot of people constantly every single day, you're less inclined to catch COVID because you're self-isolating and you aren't around a lot of people. Another pro I have to health and well-being is that it is possible to get more sleep with online school. I mean, I'm sure a lot of us are home all the time now, and when you're home all the time, it is 100% possible to get more sleep because you might have more control of your schedule, so you can rearrange your schedule to give yourself more time to sleep. Or perhaps being in lockdown might reduce the amount of things you need to do, which also gives you more free time and time you can dedicate to giving yourself more sleep. Now I just want to talk about the cons of online school with regards to health and well-being. The first con I have is that you are always sitting with online school. I always like to work at a desk, and of course when you work at a desk, you are sitting a lot. Sitting for hours in a day actually made my butt hurt, my tailbone hurt. My back and neck also became sore. There was just a lack of movement in general, which resulted in pain and soreness. It got to a point where it was just not comfortable anymore, and because this work setting was going to stay, I actually had to upgrade my home office and my home workspace so that I can be more comfortable during online school and when I'm working. Another con to online school is that you are always staring at a screen. And when you're always staring at a screen, your eyesight obviously gets worse. If you didn't know, I have glasses, and I don't need to wear my glasses all the time. I just need to put them on when my eyes get really sore, and that is often now. Like, my eyes get really sore every single day from looking at a screen, and the more I need to use my glasses, I feel like my eyes are actually getting worse. I haven't been to the optometrist yet, but I have a strong feeling that the next time I go, they're gonna say,
"Your eyesight got worse."
And it is all because of that increased screen time due to online school. I have one last con in terms of health and well-being, and this is a big one, and that is isolation might affect your mental health. I am grateful that I currently live at home with my family during this time, so I'm not completely isolated. I am just separated from my friends. But for the people who live alone, I just can't imagine how bad it might be for them. When you live alone and you're told to stay at home and isolate day in and day out, I'm sure you're gonna get very lonely. And when you're lonely for so long, you might actually become sad and depressed. And I'm sure you're just gonna find life mundane and boring when you can't do much at home. Like, that is harmful for your mental health. The next topic I wanted to cover is communication and socialization. In online school, communication with the teachers was through email, and I definitely feel like communicating through email was a lot easier. Mostly because when I had a question about an assignment, I could just shoot them an email, and the majority of my profs would reply within a few hours. Through email, I was just able to take the time to just write up my question and get all my thoughts out so that they fully understand my question in the email. I don't know if that makes sense, but basically I could just plan out my question a lot more than I could when I'm asking a question in person. The one thing I also liked about emailing your questions is that you can keep your emails forever. I find that so useful because sometimes when I ask a question, I might forget their answer down the road in a few days. In the case that happens, I could just pull up their email again and just read their answer and just be reminded of what they said. That is the main reason why I like emailing my questions. Moving on to the cons of communication and socialization. The first con I have is that you become very antisocial. Being isolated and not being able to talk to anybody in person other than my family for so long, I kind of forgot how to talk to people in public. I honestly believe that once we are able to start going out more, we are really going to have to readjust to socializing in big groups. A year not being in big groups is a long time, and it's gonna feel really weird. Lastly, for communication, I just wanna say that it is so much easier to communicate for group work in person. As you know, in my program, I have a lot of group work, and the way we communicate is through Zoom calls or group chats. I don't have anything negative to say about communicating through Zoom calls, but for group messages, I'm sure anybody who's been in a group chat will know that response times may take a couple of hours. In addition, you might not even get a response from a certain person. I don't blame them because group chats, there's probably a whole bunch of messages that may not apply to them, so they just don't read it. And when you need an answer specifically from them not seeing your message might be an accident, because I know I've done that many times in group chats. When I get so many messages and I just don't want to read it, I just end up clicking on it just to clear the new notifications, but I don't actually read it. And by doing that, I might miss a question that's directed towards me. So back to why communication in person is just so much better is because you can ask the person directly and you will get a response back. Now let's move on to lifestyle of online school. Of course, if you're doing school online at home, you can wear your PJs to school. Honestly, I'm gonna admit, I haven't worn real clothes in a while. For the past year, I've really just been wearing cozy, comfy loungewear. I've just been wearing the exact same few pieces of clothing every single week that I no longer consider them real clothes. That's just how it is. Another thing is that if your classes are asynchronous, your schoolwork becomes so flexible and you can do it whenever you want. I honestly just love asynchronous classes because if you have more time one day, for example, you could just work ahead in your work and have less work the next day or the next week. Anyways, on to the next point. Because school is online, I don't have to commute. I am someone who commutes to school every single day. I do not live on or around campus. When school is in person, I usually commute an hour just to get there. Commuting is a waste of time, in my opinion. I could be using that hour to get more sleep, or you know, watching a TV show, or using that extra hour to get work done. If I was commuting a shorter distance, I probably wouldn't mind it as much, but it's the fact that it's at least an hour long each time. The last pro I have to lifestyle is that you save so much money when school is online and when you're forced to stay at home. Because I stay home so much, I don't have a need or desire to buy new clothing. Now that I don't leave the house that often, I'm less inclined to buy lunch or buy coffee or buy tea. Also, because mostly everything is closed right now, I don't have to spend money on entertainment. So in conclusion, being forced to stay at home, I get to save quite a bit of money and my bank account is happy. Moving on to the cons of the online school lifestyle. The first thing I'd say is that every day and week is the exact same. When you pretty much do the exact same thing every single day and week, it becomes a routine. And when there's no difference in your routine, that's when I feel like I start to lose motivation to do things. This next point, I guess, is more specifically related to university and college. But when you're in online school, you really are missing out on the college university experience. I feel like a really large portion of the university college experience is being on campus, moving from class to class. As you know, because school is online, you don't get that experience. The last thing I'll say about lifestyle is that for me, I feel like I am less motivated to work out when I'm at home. I really like the gym environment because that really keeps me motivated to keep working out. The next topic is productivity. What I really like about online school is that you have more time to do your schoolwork. Of course, because of the pandemic, most things are closed. So of course, this past year I didn't have a job, I didn't have to commute, nor did I have hangouts with friends. I really didn't have to rush to complete work because I had the time to do it. Now let's talk about the cons of productivity. So when you're working from home, I feel like it is easier to get distracted at home. When you're at home, there's just so many things around you, and that just pulls you away from your schoolwork. Especially when you're on Zoom and your camera is off, you can pretty much do whatever you want behind the camera. Your teacher cannot see you and call you out for not listening in class or doing schoolwork or whatever. That is just how easy it is to lose focus focus during online school. I just think with online school, you have to be disciplined and self-motivated to do work. Next, let's talk about film school specifically. One thing I'll say about film school online is that it's better for the environment. Within film in general, there's just a lot of paperwork. For example, I was taking a screenwriting for television class this past semester, and my final assignment was to write a comedy script. If classes were in person, I'm pretty sure my prof said she would expect hard copies of the script to be submitted. So I would have to print out and submit a hard copy of a 30-page script. That would have killed a lot of trees. That is the only pro I have in terms of film school. I have a pretty long list of cons for film school. The first one being that group work is difficult online. When you're working with new people online, I feel like it's hard to get to know them and get in touch with them. One thing I strongly believe is that profs already expect you to know who you're working with. Let's say, for example, they assign you to a group. They expect you to already know those people and have contact with them. But honestly, that might not be the case. There were times this past semester where I had to go ask mutual friends for their contact information. I would also say that film school online is pretty messy and unorganized. Some of my classes have to change the entire curriculum to make it doable online. For example, some of my studio classes that are more hands-on became lectures because they could only be done through Zoom now. Another thing I'll say about online film school is that deadlines and shoots kept on being pushed back. Because of that, I had so many things due at the very end of the semester. The last thing I'll say about film school is that the majority of our work is hands-on, and online school is the exact opposite of hands-on. For example, when we were on set shooting our films, some of us were using new equipment for the first time, and because school's online, we didn't get to use the equipment or figure out how to use the equipment until the first day of shooting. When school's online, you really only learn how to use the equipment or the software theoretically. And I personally thought that learning it that way just wasn't helpful at all. I feel like I'm someone who actually needs to have it in front of them to really learn and understand what I'm working with. All right, the next topic I want to talk about is resources. So for resources, I just couldn't think of any pros. So we're just going to go right ahead and talk about cons. The first con being in-person facilities aren't open. For example, you can't really change your study or work location. I know sometimes when I work at school, I like to work at the library with friends, or work at a coffee shop, or work at the student center. But with online school during the pandemic, you can't do that because all of these facilities are closed. Also, sometimes if you want to try the traditional way of researching material by going to the library and looking at books, that is also not possible during this time. The last topic I just wanted to discuss was just online school in general. Again, this is another topic where I only have cons. The first con was that tuition was not cut. For a lot, if not all, university and colleges, our tuition prices stayed the same. Considering we're not using campus facilities, I think tuition should be cut a little bit. Sadly, it was not, and I think that's what angered a lot of people. All right, friends, that is the end of my reflection of online university this past year during the pandemic. I really hope you found this video interesting. Let me know in the comments down below if some of these things are different for you or if you can relate to some of the points I made. And with that, if you are still watching right now, you're a real one. Thank you so much for your love and support. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next video. Pull the key out the ignition. Run your mouth but I never listen. You hold me back, will never last. Keep talking all your shit. Wondering how all this started. You left me brokenhearted. You flip my words, yeah, this love hurts. Keep talking all your shit.